Welcome to this week's edition of CEO Corner. I'm Otis Rawl, President and CEO of the South Carolina Chamber of Commerce, and we're delighted today to have the South Carolina State Treasurer with us, Converse Shells. Converse, welcome.
Well, Otis, thank you so much for having me, and it's really an honor to be part of y'all's presentation.
Well, we're glad to be able to talk about fiscal responsibility in this state. Big issue, particularly in light of the fiscal problems that we've had in this state this year in deliberating with our budget. But your office released a report in January talking about the fiscal condition of our state. Can you talk about the reforms that were included in that particular report?
Sure, and I think probably one of the leading ones that makes a lot of difference to state is our AAA bond ratings. And some of the things that I found out that when I first came into office is when we visited the rating agencies. And by visiting those rating agencies, we found out some of the needs the state needs to really look at. And we have two AAA ratings and one AA+. And it's important that we look at our, and it's real simple. We've got one of the highest unemployment rates, and we need to bring that down. I mean, that is number one priority we need to work at. And when we do that, obviously when you bring the employment rate down, you have revenues coming in from that because those people are working and contributing to society. And once we have that, it takes the pressure off the rest of the citizens of South Carolina for taxing. And we're looking not only at the unemployment rate, we need to look at that, bringing that down, but we're looking at trying to increase the wealth of South Carolinians so that our average job pays more than it normally does. And with that, those are the kind of things we're looking at.
Well, I know part of the report focused on tourism and workforce development is one of the ways that we kind of stimulate that wealth process that you're talking about. So a lot of talk around workforce development issues. Why is that so important, and why do you see that so important?
Well, I see it as important for a couple of reasons. One, you raise the wealth of South Carolinians. It's go help us all across the board bring our economy into to the 21st century, so to speak. And a couple of those points that you mentioned tourism, and you mentioned the how we bring the wealth in. Well, when I was in the General Assembly, one of the important things we did was the endowed chairs. And you remember that legislation went through, and I think that's real important to understand that was a long-range plan to start bringing wealth to the state of South Carolina. And now you're starting to see some of those fruits. We've got the hydrogen fuel cell work going on. We have probably one of the nuclear facilities in the Savannah River plant. We ought to be using these tools. That's higher paying jobs. Tourism, another instance there is those people come from out of our state, they spend the dollars here, and then they leave us alone for 6-8 months. And we've got some of the greatest resources. You know, we've got the beaches, we have the mountains, we have great lakes. I live on the lakes a lot of my life here now. Right. I've been in Columbia, and it's really been great. And a lot of things that get left out of this is our port facility.
Right.
One of the best ports in the nation, and we need to increase the capacity of that port. So.
Well, I think another issue that gives, particularly the business community, a lot of concern is how our budget's written and how the state spends those dollars. And part of the report really focuses in on looking at a new revenue forecasting process, a way of leveling those type of issues out. Why is it so important? I know you talked about the AAA rating, and that goes back to it, but talk about your idea on how we should stabilize that process.
Well, there's two or three things that we've come up with, and it's going to take more than just the actual ideas. We've got to work at them. But our stabilization plan for our revenue, we need to, as a CPA, my 20 or 30 years, or actually closer to 30 or 35 years as a CPA, auditing lots of different governmental entities. One of the things that was most important is make sure they built reserve funds. We do a 3% and a 2%, roughly about a 5% between our reserve and capital reserve funds. We really need to look at maybe raising that to closer to 10%, like 2 months of revenues in abeyance for special occasions, for stuff like we're going through right now. And it would be important to look at that. That's one of the areas that we're looking at. And now the other part, you mentioned budgeting. And when I was in the General Assembly, y'all's position is maybe to start from the base budget of the previous year. Good idea, but you need to add to it maybe. And I do know at the General Assembly, they actually challenge those budgets. And if you've been over there and watched them challenge each one of those, when you were over at the Department of Revenue, you remember they challenged what y'all were paying. So the idea is to challenge it, kind of like a zero-based budget. Right. But we need to add to it the activity-based budgeting. And the reason why I say that is that there are needs of the state that we need to fund. And we need to prioritize those needs. We need to come up with a prioritization system so that we can then start planning our budget process around that, so the state it would spend less, but you just can't spend none. You
right.
can't get to zero. You got to have less spending, but you have to have it in the right spot so that that you have a good state running forward, and once it'll be a state that people want to live in,
right.
work, and do business in.